Hey everybody, welcome. It's Linda and Beth here from the Resilient Organization and the humans who work there, mostly the humans who work there. We love nothing more than serving teams, supporting teams, and we know that right now is, well, it is for all of us, even us sitting here, crazy times when we thought we'd be through this. And for those of you who lead teams, manage teams, support teams, or team members, you know, we want to give you just a couple quick tips on how you can support your team moving forward, whether you're in the office, back at home, trying to do both, not even sure where the heck you are today, or even if you have pants on, doesn't matter.
Yeah, exactly.
So we're gonna give you a quick, you know, fire action here. How would you like your team to feel this year? Ask your team, ask every one of them, send them out an email, you can ask them in person. How do you want to feel while you're doing your work? You want to be excited? You want to be feeling more calm? You want to feel more at peace? Do you want to feel encouraged or driven? Like, so just literally ask people, how literally do they want to feel?
And then once your team knows how they want to feel, like let's say calm, say I want to feel calmer. Who doesn't want to feel calmer? Oh, me, I would love to feel more calm. Calm, you can take a simple action like clean your desk.
Wonderful idea.
Right?
Yeah.
Clean your desk so that it creates a calm workspace. It's a really simple thing. Yeah. You want to feel inspired? Put something inspiring on your desk, right? It's really, we don't talk about complicated. We're just talking simple things that activate how you want to feel.
As a leader, you could send out, if people want to feel a little more motivated or inspired or supported, maybe do a morning, every other morning, a bit of an email burst out.
Yeah, Monday motivation.
Something like that.
Right?
Simple things just to get us through the beginning of this year, trying to figure out how we're going to land to come, who knows? I know, giant question mark is for everybody. So it's making us feel a little uneasy for sure.
Okay, so the second thing you could do to talk to your team about is, you know, we love to talk about resiliency, and that's what we talk about probably the most with teams. And here's the question, what is going to boost your resiliency when the going gets tough? And we know it's maybe already tough, but we can't control the external world. We can't control a lot of things, frankly. We know that more than ever right now. But what we can control is what we can do ourselves.
There's lots of things that we can do ourselves.
Right? Of how what makes you feel resilient? What makes you feel strong? What makes you feel able to cope? You know those things. But it's really great as a leader to ask your team, what are the things that help boost yourself? Is it going outside at lunch? Is it starting your day really slow?
Putting your timer on every, 45 minutes to get up and stretch. So, 'cause if you're sitting again.
Perfect one.
At home. Everybody knows the answer to this. Sometimes we need to be reminded. So just think, what are the things that would give you the biggest payoff right now? The biggest payoff in the moment. And you could, maybe you need to have a difficult conversation with someone who, you know, it's causing a bit of stress for you. Maybe you need to move your body more often. Maybe you need to start a mindful practice once a day, just to sit and just to calm down your breathing, to settle down. But which one of these things, and you know it.
Yeah, you're the expert.
You're the expert.
You're the expert. What
would give you the biggest payoff right now?
Yeah,
that's how I like to sort of lead in with this. And again,
love it.
As a leader, you could just ask your team to make a commitment and just say, hey, let's do this for a week. Give people a bit of a timeline because the going is tough right now, mostly because there's so much unknown.
Yeah, exactly.
Even the experts don't know what the heck we're doing.
No. So here's the third thing that we really love to talk about. And this is a beautiful question to ask your team. But it's like, what is your unique gift?
Yeah.
What is your contribution that you really make? I mean, we know we're hired, people are hired for their skills and their technical ability or their whatever you got hired for, but we know that we all have kind of something we really bring. So like you might have someone in your office or your team that brings humor. That's their contribution. They always can lighten things up when things are tough. Or maybe their contribution is creativity. There's out of the box and then they're always just coming up with these beautiful, amazing, innovative ideas. Is it creativity?
Yeah, of you are amazing at spreadsheets. Not me.
Yeah. Neither one of us.
So you could take all of these ideas of how people can contribute and put it on a spreadsheet.
And just go, look at our team. Here's our gifts, right? And then, in that, just, ask your people, who can support you bringing the best out in you? Because we know you can always find people who can bring out the worst in you.
Yeah.
But we need those people in our corner that bring out our best in you. You know, whether it's a colleague, a friend, your team leader, whatever, like who can you partner up so that you are always at your best?
Now, we would love to collaborate with you if you're interested in doing anything this next year. Beth and I do a lot of training, whether it's virtual or live. We do both, tons of that, and can certainly put together a customized program for you. But if nothing else, just take one step in front of the other and just move forward into 2022.
All right, have a good one.